The Lord be with you. Well, thank you. Welcome to worship this morning. I'm extra glad to see you here this morning. I've missed so many of my friends, and we're thankful for the opportunity to worship together. We're going to continue to do this as long as our Clay County COVID numbers allow. It's going to take some flexibility on our part. We've worked hard to get here. We're going to make sure that we're able to worship in a meaningful and a safe way from here forward. A couple of announcements and prayer requests I have for you today. I ask that you please keep the family of Francis Finger in your prayers, as Francis has died about 2 weeks ago. Her funeral is it's a family event. It's upcoming this week. I also ask for your prayers for Pat Cottrell, who is near death. That God bless her and keep her in his grace. We begin our worship service this morning, as always, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sin. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now let us pray. Sovereign God, raise your throne in our hearts. Created by you, let us live in your image. Created for you, let us act for your glory. Redeemed by you, let us give you what is yours. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. And we'll now have an offering of music from our chancel choir. Would you please rise as you're able for the reading of the gospel? From the gospel according to Matthew, the 22nd chapter. The Pharisees then went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. So they sent their disciples to him, along with the Herodians. These are the followers of the puppet king Herod. And they said to him, "Teacher, we know that you are sincere and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. You show deference to no one, for you do not regard people with partiality. Tell us then what you think. Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not?" But Jesus, aware of their malice, said, "Why are you putting me to the test, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that's used for this tax." And so they brought him a denarius, which is a Roman coin. And he said to them, "Whose head is this, and whose title?" And they answered him, "The emperor's." And then he said to them, "Give therefore to the emperor the things that are the emperor's, and to God the things that are God's." And when they heard this, they were amazed. They left him and they went away. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Please be seated. Let us pray. O Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. This question that they posed to him, the Pharisees who were the ones who stayed and taught the extrapolations about God's law at the temple day and night, the Herodians, they were the followers of King Herod, who was the puppet king put in place by the Roman Empire. The question that they asked him about paying taxes, of course, is a loaded one. It's a trap. It's meant to show the people in the Roman Empire where his allegiances lie, with the Jewish zealots, those who were trying to fight back and win their homeland, or would it be with the Roman overlords? They figured that they'd catch him one way or the other, and that he'd be cooked. I think they expected that in front of all of those Jewish people at the temple that he would say that his allegiances lie with them, which of course would mean that they could go tattle on him to the Romans, which is what they were looking to do in the first hymn. So they ask him about his hard-earned money and about their hard-fought land. Who does it belong to? Jesus says that the more important question is, who do you belong to? Who do you belong to? That's what he gets at with that question of whose image is on the coin. Of course, we know that on the coin it was the picture of the Roman emperor. And each time a new emperor came into power, what they would do is they'd strike new coins with the image of the new emperor on there. Whoever was in charge at that time would be the one whose face they would have to look at as they paid their tribute back to an unwanted occupier. Jesus says there's more to image than what we can carry with us. You know, this last week it was MEA week. For the school, the teachers' convention, and my kids always get a few days off from school at the end of that week. And what we typically do during that time is we go down to my wife's parents' dairy farm, and we spend 4 or 5 days down there. And we did that again, and it's always kind of fun to look at all of the kids that are there. There's quite a few of them now, more than you can wrangle, that's for certain. And as they're running around and trying to get a good look at their face, and we talk about who they look like, right? Whose image they bear. They look like Cassie, or they look like me, or brothers and sisters, maybe grandma and grandpa. It's fun to talk to the parents and the aunts and uncles about what these kids look like. And not only which of their parents they look like, but then which of their cousins they look like, too. Charlie's got one cousin that he looks just like him. So Cassie is actually pregnant right now. I know some folks know that. We're looking forward to a new baby in our family and looking forward to visiting about what that child is going to look like too, with the recognition that we're all connected. At the same time, we each look like ourselves. And in our baptism, we've been blessed to have several baptisms over the last weeks and months. We all are baptized under the same proclamation, that you are baptized in the waters of Christ. We proclaim that what we look like when everything is stripped away, at our very core and our very hearts, we look like God. We look like God. And this harkens back to Genesis chapter 1, that creation story where God says, "Let us make humankind then in our image, according to our likeness." So God created humankind in his image, the image of God he created them, male and female he created them. We bear on our hearts the image of God. Some may give their minds to God. This is one thing I read this week. Some may give their minds to God, but their hearts are far from God. Some may give their hearts, but they're unwilling to learn from God and the Word. Some may give God their muscles, but are unwilling to bring their bodies to worship or to education. Many give God 1 or 2 hours a week, but what God asks for is 168 hours a week, and that makes me sweat a little bit too. Many give God 2% of their income, or perhaps 10% of their income, but God wants 100% of them. So how do we know then, when Jesus asks them to produce this coin, he turns it back on them. On whose image is on this coin? Well, Caesar's. How do we know what belongs to Caesar then? Well, they have his image on them. And how do we know what belongs to God? Well, they have God's image on them. That's true of each and every one of us. Those who are here, those who are with us at home, those who are with us in spirit, those whom we wish were here with us, all contain the image of God. We cannot say that this part belongs to God, so I'll give this part to God. For everything we are and everything we have belongs to God. Everything we are and everything we have, we are to give back to God. This is what redemption means. We are but mere managers or stewards of these gifts that God has given us. How we use our lives and our possessions indicates the authority that we put our lives under. Jesus gives all of himself, his whole being, back to God. And I was thinking about that this week, that he gives all of himself over to God. And I think at first blush, that might seem to be the thing that like differentiates him from us. But that can't be true if he asks us to do the same. Offering his whole self back over to God is not what makes him different than us, because he invites us to give of ourselves the same way. I think maybe what makes him different than us is that he also gives himself over to us. That life poured out for the sake of his friends, his brothers and sisters. This is the fullness of love. Not just that he loves God, but that he loves all. And the fullness of love knows no limits. You are created in this same image. You have the blessing to live and give your life in the image of God. And by Christ's death and resurrection, you are once and for all redeemed in the image of God by the one who created you and all that is. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Oh, Master. shining ray, far down the future's broadening way, in peace that only thou canst give, with thee, O Master, let me live.
Change things around and you have to train me in again. So we are people who belong to God, and as those people we join together in prayer. I will end each petition with, Lord, in your mercy, for those who are here, I invite you to quietly say it, but in your heart to loudly and joyfully call out, hear our prayer. For those watching from home, I invite you to do the same, but you can call it out as loud as you wish. Let us pray. Holy God, to whom we belong, guide us. Guide us as we live in this world to be your people, to serve those in need, to share ourselves with others, to give our all to you, our God. Lord, in your mercy, God of praise, the season is changing to cold and snow. Trees have lost their leaves, some birds have flown south, some mammals are hibernating, other animals have grown a heavier coat of fur. Amidst all these changes in nature, you remain our loving God, and we give you our thanks. Lord, in your mercy, God of all, as Americans are voting, we pray that you draw us together. Draw us together as people who belong to you and who are also Americans. Fill us with peace and unity and calm, that without regard for political preferences, we may all work that your will be done in our country and throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy, God of all healing, we pray for those with physical or mental pain, illness, isolation, grief, anger, or doubt. We pray for the family and friends of Francis Finger, for Pat Cottrell, for all whom we name before you in our hearts, and for all who have no one to name them. Use us, Lord, to bring your healing to them. Lord, in your mercy, God of life, we give you thanks for the lives of those who have died since we were last together. Receive them into your loving arms. Pour your comfort into those who mourn, and fill us with the courage and strength to continue our lives serving you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of our saviors, we ask your blessing on all who have come to church to worship you, on all who are or will worship you via Facebook, and on all who have no way to join us but do truly worship you. Draw us all together as your loving people, people who belong to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear us as we call on you, O God, and enfold us all in your loving arms. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, and all God's people called out, Amen.
At this time, we would normally be collecting our offerings, your offerings. For this time forward, we're going to be asking you to please, if you've brought offerings, put them on the offering plates on your way out of worship service. Also, you'll notice in the front of you is a yellow attendance sheet, essentially. If you would please fill those out for us as well so we can keep track of who's been here. And you can hand those in also in that offering plate on your way out of worship service. And on your way in, you should have perhaps grabbed a cup of communion. If you have not done so, please raise your hand and maybe we can make sure that you get that. We pray now for all our offerings. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. If you have your communion cup, would you hold that in your hand as we commence with the meal? On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord took bread. He broke it, gave thanks, and gave it for all to eat, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup, blessed it, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Lord, remember us in your kingdom. Teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. This is the body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. Well, I've sure missed that. Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you've refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us through this gift, in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. My friends, receive now God's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. We now hear our last musical offering for the day.
Consider all
Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.